Hello, welcome back in LADALIDI's tutorial. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to create this equalizer slider button as I promised in the previous video. To create an equalizer like this, we still use this radial brushed metal button that I made in the previous video on the card above, or you can find the link in the description. After that, create a track path for the button. Add lines as level indicators for the equalizer and some additional elements so that the result can be like this. And without any further ado, let's jump into Adobe Illustrator. I have prepared a document with a size of 1920 by 1980 pixels with RGB color mode. I don't need to show you how to make this background gradient and radial brushed metal button because I have shown you in the previous video. First, create a rectangle horizontally using the rectangle tool, 10 pixels wide and 600 pixels high. After that, use the direct selection tool to make it round. Zoom in a bit to get a closer look at the ends of this square. And if you find a dot in the inside of the corner, then it's a corner widget. You'll find it in the other corner. Just click and drag towards the inside of the square to make it round, and the other end will follow as well. Now, we will remove the black line on this rectangle. Click the stroke box in the toolbar and click the None button, then reactivate the fill box. Open the gradient panel to give it a gradient color. Change the angle to 90 degrees. Double-click the left color stop to open the swatches panel and choose the dark blue color. Double-click on the other color stop and give it a light blue color. Or you can use other colors and just play with brightness. Now we are going to give it an edge effect to get a dimensional effect. While this rounded blue rectangle is still selected, go to the object menu, path, offset path. Fill the offset with 0.5 pixels, leave everything else at default and click OK. Open the swatches panel and give it a light gray color. Next, make sure this rounded gray rectangle is still selected. Go back to the object menu, pad, offset pad. This time, fill the offset with 10 pixels, click OK. Open the gradient panel. Replace the color of one of these color stops with a lighter gray and the other with a darker gray. When finished, open offset path panel again in the object menu. Fill the offset with 0.5 pixels. Then give it a lighter gray color, just like the blue rounded rectangle. After we create these four rounded rectangles, now we are going to give it an inner shadow, however by using an inner glow, because you will never find the inner shadow effect in Illustrator. Select this blue rounded rectangle because this is what we will give the inner shadow effect first. Go to the effect menu, stylize, inner glow. To get the same effect as the inner shadow, we just need to change the color to black. Change the mode to multiply. Opacity 34%. Blur 5 pixels. And click OK. After giving the effect of inner shadow on this blue round rectangle, then we will also give the same effect to the larger gray rounded rectangle. Do the same as before. Effect, stylize, and inner glow. We don't need to make any adjustment to this panel. Just click OK and done. We have finished creating the path for this equalizer slider button by giving it a sense of depth or a three-dimensional appearance. And now we just need to give it an indicator line, and this step is much easier. Just create a short horizontal line using the line segment tool. Select the line segment tool and click anywhere on the artboard. Fill length with 10 pixels and an angle of 0 degrees. Open the stroke panel in the collapse panel, but if the strokes panel is not already saved in your workspace, you can simply open it directly in the control panel overview. Here, in the stroke panel, change the stroke width to 2 points and set it to round cap. After that, give it the same gray color as the gray slider path. Now we just have to duplicate it along the path of this equalizer slider. You can use the transform tool in the effect menu, but I prefer to duplicate it by using the blend tool. I'll show you why I prefer to use the blend tool over using the transform tool. First of all, place the short line parallel to the top end of the slider path. Then duplicate this short line by holding down the Alt key on your keyboard and dragging it until it's at the bottom end. Once duplicated, activate the blend tool and start selecting the first line and select the other one. After the two lines are blended, we will determine the number of lines between these two main lines by opening the blend option panel. And quick way to open the blend options panel is to double click the blend tool in the toolbar. If it doesn't work, you can go to the object menu, blend, blend options, change the spacing tab to specified step, and give it a value of 18, which means there will be 18 lines between the two lines plus two starting lines. And it's just that easy. That's why I prefer to use the blend tool to duplicate them, because we can define the starting and ending positions of these lines. When we use the transform tool, we must first know the length of the lines that we will duplicate, and I think it takes more time to figure out the size. Finally, just leave this radial brushed metal button above the slider. Once done, select all of them, right click and group. Press the Alt key on the keyboard and drag to duplicate it. Press Ctrl plus D on the keyboard to repeat the duplication. Change the Ctrl key to Command if you are using a Mac. Do it repeatedly until you get the number of duplications you want. Now we just add a number as a level indicator on this equalizer slider. And this slider equalizer is done. And you see, we only use Adobe Illustrator to create a 3D equalizer slider like this. You don't need to use a 3D application to create it, where we just start creating a rounded rectangle, then duplicate it to a wider shape using an offset path. Use inner glow to get the inner shadow effect. Give it a level indicator line. And finally, we just press a button on it. It's very simple, very easy. By the way, you can also open the link on the card above for the tutorial how to create an audio wave graphic, or you can find the link in the description box. If this tutorial was helpful, don't forget to like, share, and click the subscribe button and the notification bell if you want to get more useful tutorials in the future. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask me in the comment, and see you in the next tutorial.